As you said earlier, Dream, Ric Flair and Bret the Hitman Hart one-on-one. The Giant to collide with Kevin Nash in the match we understand will happen. Kevin Nash will be there. And many more matches. Lex Luger and the Macho Man Randy Savage. Chris Benoit will finally get in the ring against Raven. And then, of course, Larry Zbysko and Scott Hall.
Well, you know, a lot was said this past week, Tony. You know, on Nitro and on TBS's new Thunder that rolled across our television sets. Let me tell you something. That hatred burned so deep between Scott Hall and the legendary Larry Zbysko. One point was brought up when you were sitting there on one of your major announcements that Scott Hall is not the Scott Hall of 10 years ago. He's a lot better.
Oh, yeah.
He's a lot stronger. He's a lot meaner. And he learned his trade very well. So I hope, once again, I'm going to say this, that the legendary Larry Zbysko doesn't take him too light. You know what I mean? Does that make any sense? You know what I'm saying? I mean, because I guarantee you, he's out to hurt the legendary Larry Zbysko. He's out to punish him. And no doubt about it, the legend Larry Zbysko can get it done. The pretzelizer of all pretzelizers. But this thing, I think, is brewing and runs a little bit deep, is all I'm saying. It's that Minnesota connection that I'm talking about. And you not being up there during that time, that era, I know what they're talking about. And it runs deep, Tony. I'm telling you, it's going to be serious business.
Yeah, it's going to be a serious matchup.
Yes.
Larry Zbysko has a lot going for him now, a lot of momentum. But you're right. You don't discount Scott Hall. Here's a man that won World War III.
No, Tony, you come out of retirement, okay? And who will... Now, World War III, that's okay, too. As we watch Joey Maggs here trying to get off on Brad Armstrong, let me tell you something. You brought up two good things right there that we touched on but didn't touch on yet. Scott Hall winning that thing makes him eligible to wrestle for the World Heavyweight title, which is held by nobody right now, right? That's in limbo right now. See, I was looking forward to seeing this thing come off with Scott Hall.
We were going
to
see Scott Hall and Sting at Super Bowl.
Exactly.
Right.
So now we don't know what James J. Dillon and the committee got in store. Let me tell you something else, though, on the second thought of that thing right there, too. Larry Zbysko, when you, like you said, you feel good about yourself. I know I get up in the morning. Even though my mind is saying run, my body is a walking. And so I'm just saying, if you come out of retirement after a while and you're in there with some young gun like Scott Hall, I'm just saying, be cautious. Remember I said that before.
Sure.
But anyway.
I understand.
And Joy Maggs, obviously... drought from the pay window definitely wants to get there against the Armstrong, but I don't believe that Brad is gonna let him get there in this thing. I'm telling you, if I had to pick one or two.
Sure, Brad is just too talented.
And I'm talking more giving you a break, because I know that you have done like 15 or 30 hours of television this past week. You're so good, Silver Tongue. It's precious to watch you
television.
I'm kind of put in the play-by-play too a little bit there, and I'll back off now.
And I appreciate your hollow concern, but you do understand.
Oh,
hollow concern. You do understand that no one gives Skip Carey a break of 162 Braves games. Now,
yeah, but wrestling's not baseball.
Yeah, I know.
Baseball could be
on the outside.
Baseball could be called by your son. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Fly ball to left field. I mean, you know, we're talking business here.
Down low is Brad Armstrong.
Speaking of baseball,
Brad Armstrong has nothing to do with baseball.
My good friend, Skip Carey, and Joe Simpson. But hats off, congratulations, Don Sutton, Hall of Fame. It's a long time
overdue,
man.
Overdue's the word.
He's one of my favorites of all time, and they are our colleagues.
They're the best baseball announcers in the business.
Anywhere, okay.
Full arm dragon twist into a hammerlock now. Jumping Joey Maggs as Armstrong tries to go to the rope. And Mickey J calling for the break. Blocked by Maggs. Nicely done, but couldn't block the second one that time.
Go!
Head first.
Very aggressive. Armstrong is very aggressive. He's been that way lately and has been to the pay window. And I guarantee you, on PBS on Saturday night, he wants to go ahead and do it. Joey Maggs, Tony, has not been able to get off in an offensive mode this whole match.
But he's attempted to, Dream. You got to give him effort, an A for effort, because Joey Maggs always puts out a good effort.
No, he's always there for the fight. You're right.
One, two, got a two count. Brad Armstrong over top. Still to come. Do not forget, Kurt Hennig of the NWO will be here. Booker T defends a TV title against the Disco Inferno. Rick Martel will make his debut here on Saturday night. Plus, Diamond Dallas Page, Chris Jericho for the U.S. Heavyweight title. Into the midsection, Joey Maggs. An uppercut. Into the corner goes Brad Armstrong. To the other side.
Got him up high.
Back body drop, and he hits hard on the mat.
I'm going to tell you what, absorbed a lot of pain right there. Joey Maggs cannot back off of him. We talked about his offensive mode, what he had to be doing right there as he stepped into an old thumb in the eye. Misses with the kick right there. Brad stepping in. Whoa.
Submission hold on the ankle, on the knee. And Joey Maggs says, yes, I've had enough. A brand new move applied here by Brad Armstrong. It's pretty darn good.
Yes, it was. And you know, I take my hat off to Brad because he's in there going for the goal, getting to the pay window. Look for him to do big things in 98.
Now let's go to the locker room and our very close friend, Mean Gene Okerlund.